Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today, we're going to spend a little bit of time talking about different lighting options you can have for your ATV or side-by-side. Specifically, our test bed, well, we're going to use the lighting system off of our 2009 Yamaha YFC450R. Now, if you spend most of your time riding during the day, well, this probably won't affect you. But if you like riding at night, it's a whole different world at night. Sometimes you may need a little bit better, a little bit more brighter, or a little bit different color lighting, depending on what type of environment that you're in. So in this video, we are going to look at the difference in between the stock halogen, an aftermarket halogen, an LED, and then an HID. And what we're going to be measuring after I set up a test bench is going to be current draw, heat, and then we're actually going to measure the lumens just at a standard distance to determine which one was actually the brightest. Well, we pretty much all know the HID is going to win on the brightness factor, but is it worth it with that current draw and the amount of heat that's going to build up? Well, that's what we're going to pick into and figure out. So if you give me a few minutes, I'll set up a test bench and we'll start working our way through all four of these lights. So let's go. All right, guys, here's what I've got set up on the table. We're going to be feeding this with just a battery, and it's going to be maintained by a charger, and we're going to monitor that with this multimeter. Now, we're going to be measuring the current draw with this multimeter, and it'll be changed from circuit to circuit depending on if we're looking at high or low. Now, beyond that, we're using an app on my phone, which is going to be measuring the output of the light itself. Now, whatever this number may be, it's really not that important because we're going to keep the housing at a certain distance, at a certain angle, and we're just basically looking for the percent difference in between the different lights, not so much the absolute number that this phone app may be giving us. Now, the other thing I don't want to take into consideration is the heat dissipation, because I've heard that some of these lights get so hot they will actually melt the housing. So we'll be taking a measurement of the lens itself using an infrared temp gun after 4 minutes for each light. All right, guys, here's where we ended up. For the current draw for each one, on the stock, your high and low were both at 2.4 amps. On the PIAA halogen, both high and low were at 2.9. For the LED, only 1.4 amps. Now for the HID, it had a high of 3.2 and a low of 2.9, not bad at all. Now on the light output itself, for the stock you had 410 lumens, both high and low. For the PIAA, you had 475 on the high, 380 on the low. For the LED, you had 415 and 340. But on the HID, look at this, 1480 for the high and 555 for the low. Now all of the voltages, they were all in line, no big variations at all. Now as far as the lens temp, well, we had 145 for the stock, 140 for the PIAA halogen, 120 for the LED, and only 150 for the HID. So that concern I had about possibly melting the enclosure, well, not going to be an issue with especially using these particular four bulbs. All right, guys, that is going to wrap up the data acquisition part of this particular video. What we're going to do next is a real world test. We're going to go ahead and remount this light enclosure back into the unit and then do a real world comparison in between the stock side and the aftermarket lights with the lights turned off so we can get a better idea of what they really look like when you install them on your machine. So give me a few minutes and we'll get that set up. So first, let's look at the stock image. It's doing okay, but it's basically just shooting a straight path right down the middle. Next, let's look at the PIAA. It's giving a very similar path or pattern as the stock, but as you can tell, it's quite a bit brighter and has a little bit more of an elliptical shape to it that spans up and low more than the stock did. Next, let's take a look at the LED. It has a good pattern that shows far off and close up, but it's not very bright. Last but not least, let's look at the HID, and as predicted, it is going to be the brightest, has the best pattern as far as showing further down the trail as well as close up, but we pretty much knew that before we started.
And last, let's look at all four together, and you be the judge. Which one would you rather be looking at while you're going down the trail at night?
Well, all right, guys, that's going to wrap up this video. Hopefully I've given you enough information so you can decide which bulb is going to best fit your needs. For me, I'm going to stick with the PIAA halogens, but I think they're the best bang for the buck. Well, listen, if you need any parts for your machine, why don't you come see us at Partzilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have any questions or comments about this video, leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer. And hey, if you like what you see, why don't you go ahead and hit that subscribe button? That way you can keep up with whatever I'm working on next. We just want to say thank you for shopping here with us at Partzilla, and we will see you in the next video. Y'all have a great day.